Hi, welcome back to my channel. My name is Gina. In this video, we are going to talk about how to find an area between curves using integrals. Let f of x and g of x represent functions such that f of x is always greater than or equals to g of x over the interval a to b. So we want to find the area between f of x and g of x over the interval a to b. And we are going to use the Riemann sum, meaning we are going to split this area into smaller rectangles, and we are going to sum all the rectangles. So to do that, we are going to subdivide the interval a to b into smaller subintervals. And let's call the length of each subinterval delta x. And let's look at one rectangle at a time. For example, let's consider this rectangle. So we want to find the area of this rectangle. Let's call the y value at the top, y top, and the y value at the bottom, y bottom. So the height of this rectangle is y top minus y bottom, or f of x minus g of x. And the width of one rectangle is the width of the subinterval, which is delta x. And if we have infinitely many subintervals, then this delta x will become dx. And the area of any rectangle is the base times the height. So the area of this rectangle is f of x minus g of x, which is the height of the rectangle, times its width, dx. So the total area, the area that we want to find, we take the integral of area of one rectangle, f of x minus g of x, dx, and we evaluate the integral from a to b. Let's look at this example. We want to find the area bounded by f of x equals to 0, h of x equals to x, g of x equals to 1, and k of x equals to ln of x. And they are shown on this graph. The blue curve is f of x. The red curve is h of x. The purple curve is g of x. And the green curve is k of x. So we want to find the area bounded between these four curves, meaning we want to find this area. At first, it might look complicated because here we have an area bounded between four curves, but we can actually split this area into two areas. So the area on the left is the area bounded between h of x and f of x over the interval 0 to 1. And the area on the right is the area bounded between g of x and k of x bounded between 1 and their intersection point here. To find this intersection point, we can let g of x equals to k of x. That is 1 equals to ln of x. So their intersection point is at x equals to e. So the total area will be the integral of h of x minus f of x dx evaluated from 0 to 1 plus the area on the right, which is integral of g of x minus k of x, evaluated from 1 to e. Now let's substitute the functions into this equation here. So the total area equals to integral of h of x is x minus f of x, which is 0. evaluated from 0 to 1, plus the area on the right, integral of g of x, which is 1, minus k of x, which is 1 of x, evaluated from 1 to e, which equals to integral of x, evaluated from 0 to 1, plus integral of 1, evaluated from 1 to e, minus integral of 1 of x, evaluated from 1 to e. Let's call the first integral I1, and the second integral I2, and the third integral I3. So I1, integral of x evaluated from 0 to 1 equals to x squared over 2 evaluated from 0 to 1, which equals to 1 over 2. And y2, which equals to integral of 1 evaluated from 1 to e, and this equals to e minus 1. Now let's look at I3. Integral of 1 of x evaluated from 1 to e. Here we can use the integration by parts. Let f be ln of x, and g prime be 1. So f prime is 1 over x, and g is x. So this integral equals to x times ln of x evaluated from 1 to e minus integral of f prime times g, which is 1, evaluated from 1 to e, which equals to e times ln of e, which is 1, minus 1 times ln of 1, which is 0, and minus the integral of 1, which equals to x, and evaluated from 1 to e. So this equals to e minus e minus 1, which equals to 1. Now let's put everything together. The total area is I1 plus I2 minus I3, which is 1 over 2 plus e minus 1 and minus 1, which equals to e plus 1 over 2 minus 2, which equals to e minus 3 over 2. And that's the end of the video. If you are interested in learning more calculus too, I'll put the link to my online course down below. If you like my videos, please like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.